learn about classifying rational numbers. So let's break that down. Classifying. Classifying means grouping, okay? Mathematicians like to put things into groups. We like to have things organized. So that's classifying. Then rational. That's a certain kind of number that I'm going to give you the definition for in just a minute. And you can see right here, I talked about grouping the rational numbers. That's a very large group of numbers. So first we're going to start off with some definitions. Okay, first thing, whole numbers. Now you'll need to make sure to write down these definitions. Whole numbers, they are the counting numbers starting with zero. So you have 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. They're the basic numbers that you learn first, okay, starting with zero. And the whole numbers are only the positives and zero. So that's your whole numbers. Our next group, so whole numbers is your smallest group. This next group called integers is the next largest group. And your integers are the whole numbers, so 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on, and their opposites. Remember, opposites means it's the same number but with a different sign. So the opposite of positive 1 is negative 1. Opposite of positive 2 is negative 2. So your integers are 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on, all those positive numbers, but also with their negatives, their opposites. So negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, and so on. Okay? So you've got whole numbers, that's your smallest group, and then you've got your integers, which is your next largest group. Now the next largest group that we'll be talking about is the rational numbers. Okay? Again, we're writing down these definitions. Rational numbers are numbers that can be written as a ratio. And if you don't remember what a ratio is, remember a ratio is another way of writing a fraction. Okay? So if you can write the number as a fraction, it can be a rational number. These rational numbers also include repeating decimals. So you know how sometimes you get that decimal, it's 0.33333 on and on and on? That's a rational number, the repeating decimals. And then also you have terminating decimals, so decimals that just stop. 0.25, there's nothing after the 5, that's a terminating decimal. So it is also a rational number, because you could take your repeating decimal or your terminating decimal and you can write them as fractions. So examples of some rational numbers. We've got 3/5, 2 1/8, so mixed numbers. 2, let's think about why is 2 a rational number but also an integer? Any integer or whole number, you can always write it over 1. If you put it over 1, well, you've turned it into a fraction. And any number that can be written as a fraction is a rational number. So integers are a type of rational number, but they're like a subset of it, okay? Then you have 0.3 repeating, that little repeating bar on top, that repeating decimal, that's a rational number. And then here, negative 3. Can you write negative 3 as a fraction? You sure can. Negative 3 over 1. If you can write it as a fraction, it can be a rational number. Okay? So those are the three types of numbers that we have. Now we'll talk about how they are organized. As I said, your smallest group of numbers, your most specific type of group, is the whole numbers. 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on. The next largest group is the integers. Now the integers includes all the numbers in the whole numbers plus those negative numbers. Then you got your rational numbers. Your rational numbers are the whole numbers together with the integers, and then together with anything that doesn't fit into either the integer group or the whole number group. So we've got some ones over here that we're going to classify right now. So our first one, 0.8. It's a decimal. It is a terminating decimal, so it's going to be a rational number. It's not an integer because remember, integers, no decimals. It's not a whole number. Again, whole numbers, no decimals. So it's got to be a rational number, 0.8. So he goes right there. All right, we did that one. Now negative 10. Could negative 10 be a rational number? Yes, because you can say it's negative 10 over 1, but is that the most specific, the smallest group we could put in? No. The smallest group you can put negative 10 in is the integers, okay? It can't be in the whole numbers because remember whole numbers, there's no negatives. So negative 10, the smallest group it can go in is the integers. So we have that one there. Now, negative 1.44. Okay, a lot of people get tempted when they see a negative sign. Oh, integers. Right here, negative 1.44. That 0.44, that takes it out of the integer category. Okay, remember integers, they're just like plain Jane numbers, but with a positive or a negative. Okay, if it's got a decimal in it, it's got to be in the rational number. So negative 1.44 is a rational. All right. Now next one, 1.0. I see a decimal, but what's after that? A zero. So do we even have to write that as 1.0? No. We can write it as just simply 1. Now let's think about where we're going to put 1. Is 1 a rational number? Yes. But is that the most specific group that it will go in? No. Okay. Is 1 an integer? Yes. But is integers the most specific group for 1? No. Because think about it. 1, it's a whole number. Remember your whole numbers. 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on. The smallest group that 1 will fit in is the whole numbers. So it's got to go in the smallest group right there, the whole numbers. So 1 is a whole number. Now 13. No decimal there. Okay. Is 13 an integer? Yes, but is that the most specific group for it? No. Because remember, integers is all the positives and the negatives. Now, if it was negative 13, then integers would be the most specific group for it. But it's positive 13. So it's going to go in that whole number group. Because the whole numbers is just like your regular numbers that you learned to count with at the beginning. Negative 6. Okay. It's a negative, and it's not got a decimal, so we can confidently put that in the integers. So negative 6, that's an integer. Alright, 5 2/3. The 5, that's the whole number part, okay? But then we have this 2/3. Can you write 5 2/3 as a fraction? Yes, you can write it as an improper fraction. Right now it's a mixed number. Remember, 3 times 5, that's 15, plus 2, that's 17. Over 3. Have you written this number as a fraction? Yes. It's got to be a rational number. So 5 2/3 goes in the rational number group. Okay? If you're still a little confused about it, think about bowls, okay? I've got 3 bowls here. I have a large bowl, a medium bowl, and a small bowl. Putting numbers in their different groups is like putting different items in the bowls, okay? Some items, if they fit in this smallest bowl, well, guess what? They're also going to fit into the larger bowl, the medium bowl here, and then into the largest group there. That's like the whole numbers. So your whole numbers is like your smallest bowl. Then you got your integers, okay? Maybe there's something that doesn't quite fit into the small bowl, but it will fit into the medium bowl. And guess what? If it fits into the medium bowl, it's also going to fit into the large bowl. Then there are some things where they won't fit into either the whole numbers or the integers. The only group for them is the large bowl, the rational numbers. So just kind of remember, it's like how you learn the numbers. What did you learn first? 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4. What did you learn next? Well, there's 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4, and then there's negatives also, so that's your integers. And then after that, you started learning about positives and negatives and fractions and decimals and all these different kinds of numbers. So the ones that don't fit in 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, which are your whole numbers, or the positive and the negative numbers, which are your integers, well, they gotta have a place to go, and that's the rational numbers, which is like the big bowl. So anytime you're classifying numbers, you wanna make sure that you're putting the number in the smallest group that it can go into. Because think about, like, if you're eating some cereal, okay? Are you gonna put a normal size serving of cereal in the largest bowl? Would that make the most sense? No. Would you even put it inside a medium bowl if it's a normal size serving? No. You're going to put it in a regular cereal bowl because you don't want to have too much bowl because it's going to be awkward to eat it. So whenever you're categorizing the numbers, make sure you're putting it in the smallest group that it will fit in. Okay, and now to make sure you've got it, I want you to try these three numbers on your own. So negative 1/2, negative 4, and 0. You're going to classify whether they are a whole number, an integer, or a rational number. So get that down in your notebook, and I'll check it for you and make sure you got it.